Here's TMU English presentation podcast. And honestly, by the way, honorable judge, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, good evening. I feel really honored to stand here and make a speech. Today, I would like to take this opportunity to look together with you into this topic. From outbreak to pandemic therapy, observing the 2014 reflect on the current terrifying that can be safe. Look, this is a trace of you. Alright, its name is Ebola. Ebola was first identified in 1976 in Zaire, starting occurring in the late in Africa. Many people were infected with it, and about that. It was a dark time, you know, a dark time. From December 2013 to January 2016, it was from outbreak to pandemic, from West Africa to the world, from what most people think only in the primitive countries to the developed world. So, what was Ebola outbreak, and how did it become a pandemic? Let this document show us more detail of the process. First of all, it is generally believed that the virus is linked to fruit bat, and local citizens try the fruit bat. Second, many people in this area believe in psychic, and they were lack of trust in scientific medical procedure and facility. Third, the final farewell. They are too close to the disease, and also the disease. Moreover, the global north is not providing enough aid or attention. It was not until August that WHO management confirmed the Ebola virus disease outbreak as a public health emergency of international concern. It was too late. Therefore, this variety of circumstances led to a terrible pandemic from West Africa to the United States and Europe. After knowing the Ebola virus disease from outbreak to pandemic therapy, nowadays, you know what? Return to our world again! But this time, it has a little bit changed. It changed in a more evolved COVID-19. And we can find that these two villain stories have something in common. First, COVID-19 is thought to be linked to death. Second, China government and their professional doctors, just like the local citizen, ignore their doctors. Third, WHO declared COVID-19 outbreak as a public health emergency of international concern too late. Fourth, our world did not provide enough help to China when it outbreak. We only lost them for building the capital for Shenzhen Hospital. This emergency of pandemic culture is no longer limited to China, but starts spreading to our world. So, how can we defend against the dark when you know what's possible? There's already one answer in my mind, that is to learn something from this time Taiwanese larger. When other countries have experienced exponential growth of cases, Taiwan has managed to control the disease. It is impressive, but not surprising, because we took enough precautions. At the beginning, our system took this very seriously, following the advice of doctors and experts. And everybody did their part to wear masks and keep social distance. Not only that, because we know we are a part of global community, then we are here to help. We give the world the real information and adequate assistance. In the end, of my presentation. I want to hold my friends' hands and help them to live around the world to be safe and sound. If there's one thing that COVID-19 can understand, it is love. It didn't realize the love as powerful as united of people all over the world. United, we stand. Divided, we fall. We sincerely hope the entire world can get through the pandemic. Stay safe, stay healthy, and stay connected. It will end. We will hug each other again. Thank you very much.
Thank you for the presentation. What did we see from these young people? Imagination and also